leaked, and the Clinton people would tell you leaked all the time throughout the campaign. So there were constantly stories on the front pages of the newspaper about the state of the investigation. This is the FBI that released a letter 10 days beforehand at the urging of Peter Strzok, who helped draft the memo that was released 10 days before. And there's not a historian that writes a book on the 2016 election, Willie, that won't say that that put wind back in Donald Trump's sails. His campaign was down in some polls by 10, 11, 12 points around that time. And he came back and he won. And that was the FBI. And he praised the FBI when things went his way, condemned them when they didn't. All of these people, too, Republicans. Rod Rosenstein, Republican. Bob Mueller, Republican. James Comey was a lifetime Republican. Andrew McCabe, you don't have to register Republican or Democrat in Virginia, but he voted in the Republican primary. They're all Republicans.
Chris Wray.
The Supreme Court, controlled by Republicans. Chris Wray, the FBI director, a Republican. It is Republicans who are saying
it's also that
this
the FBI,
memo is reckless.
It's also the FBI that never disclosed that Donald Trump and his campaign was under investigation during the campaign. There were all these disclosures, as Joe has rightly said, about the Clinton campaign, which probably very seriously damaged her chances of winning. But the fact that collusion between the Trump campaign and the Russians in their meddling was under investigation never was disclosed. I think a lot of the statements that Donald Trump has made in connection with the release of the Nunes memo may well come back to haunt him as evidence of obstruction, because what we're seeing is obstruction of justice unfolding in real time right before us.
So, Senator, given that landscape and given, you know, your comments just now about obstruction, could you legitimately include, I mean, you're from a prosecutor, Attorney General of the State of Connecticut. If you take Devin Nunes's statements about the memo and about the ongoing investigation and you look at the weirdly constructed statement that is about to be released, apparently, what about Devin Nunes obstructing justice?
I think there is probably a credible case involving Nunes as well, not just in what we know publicly, but in conversations that no doubt took place between him and the White House, which evidently was involved in drafting that 3.5-page memo. What we don't know is all of those private communications, and as you well know, Nunes himself was under investigation by the House Ethics Committee for the unprecedented and hugely embarrassing visits he had with the White House just a year or so ago. So there is a lot there that I think could come back to haunt him too.